Hello from Rappel Cybersecurity. Welcome to the ISO SAE 21434 training. The purpose of this series of presentations is to make you familiar with this standard and show how you can apply it to your organization and project. It is organized in three parts, as you see on the screen. Now we are starting part one, general considerations. Some points to remind before we start. Firstly, this presentation is not intended to be used for certification because certification requires a rigorous multi-dimensional approach that can just be fully presented in a video. Secondly, ISO 21434 is not free, so you need to purchase a license to have full access. Therefore, only a limited content is provided on the slides. Third, we try to put references and links to all information that we present. And last, feel free to distribute or display this presentation as long as the content is not altered by any means. The table provided here is just an example to highlight certain cybersecurity roles in an organization. Many other roles can be introduced, of course, depending on the company and project structure. Please pay attention to the cybersecurity manager who is supposed to work with both project-dependent and independent teams. Four subsections will be presented. Listen carefully, as you will be tested at the end. ISO is a global network of national standards bodies, and these bodies represent their countries. Full members or member bodies, they influence ISO standards development and strategy by participating and voting in ISO technical and policy meetings. They are authorized to sell and adopt. As we see on the map, full members clearly dominate other types of memberships. Correspondent members, they observe the development of ISO standards and strategy by attending ISO technical and policy meetings. Like full members, they are authorized to sell and adopt standards nationally. Subscriber members, they keep up to date on ISO's work but cannot participate in them. They cannot sell or adopt ISO standards. There is one thing which is quite remarkable about this map is almost all countries are interested in ISO standards development and they are willing to participate in this activity. If you click on the countries in the map, you will see the member pages of each country. For example, here you can see the page of AFNOR, which is the certification and standardization authority of France. You can also see the different services which are provided by AFNOR here. It is also possible to participate in the development of standards via the member bodies. This generally comes with a fee depending on the technical committee and the company size. Your advantage will be to participate in the definition of market rules, develop technological awareness, and negotiate with other country members, and of course, have the chance to exchange with other privileged commission members. Please consult the member body page of your country to learn how you can participate. The member body of US in ISO is NC, which is the American National Standards Institute. We can say that NC is the legal seat of SAE in ISO. So it plays an important role in the collaboration between ISO and SAE that we will see in the upcoming slides. The standards are prepared by technical committees, and ISO SAE 21434 is a work of Technical Committee 22 road vehicles. Member bodies can participate to several committees in parallel, like we see here. For example, France participates to 754 technical committees at the same time. For further information about ISO commissions, I recommend you to consult the link at the bottom of the page. Note that certain information is only accessible by members. SAE is seen like the ISO of US, because the mission of these two organizations, I mean ISO and SAE, are quite the same, so which is developing standards. However, there is a clear difference between the two in terms of organization. SAE work is carried out by volunteer engineers all around the world who don't represent any organization. On the other hand, ISO work is handled by member bodies who represent their nations. SAE has approximately 128,000 experts all around the world, and 9,000 of them worked in development of standards. Likewise, ISO, it is possible to volunteer in the development of SAE standards. A personal membership fee is required for this. SAE and ISO started a collaboration in November 2016 to respond to a need to standardize increasingly complex mobile systems, which obliged to make collaborative efforts. Why? To avoid duplication and reduce costs. So this was very simple. More importantly, the standards would benefit from the combined expertise of ISO and SAE, optimizing the resources and making the standards more effective and relevant to the market. Within this collaboration, standards related to wireless charging, vehicle interoperability, automated vehicle level definition, and automotive cybersecurity are addressed. As you can see, the collaboration scope is much larger than cybersecurity. It is also important to note that 82 entities from different domains, including OEMs and suppliers, have participated in the development. As a result, the DIS version, so which is the first version for public, was released in February 2020, and 1 year after, the FDIS version was released. The official release was in August the same year, 2021. All of these phases are very well explained, and they are transparent to everyone in ISO waiting page for the ones who are interested. So you can see the link at the bottom of the page. What is the difference between ISO SAE 21434 and UNR 155? This is a very common question that we will reply in detail in the second part of the training dedicated to the regulation and the standard. The short answer is, former is a standard, the latter is a regulation. The standards, they don't include contractual, legal, or statutory requirements. That means they are not mandatory. However, some of them or part of them might eventually render obligatory due to being referenced by a regulation requirement. For example, ISO 8217 on petroleum products is a standard which became mandatory. In fact, the World Trade Organization has developed 6 principles that you can see on the screen to ensure that the voluntary nature of the standards is always preserved and creates no obstacle for trade. Standards are highly dense and well-structured documents that are extensively reviewed, really extensively reviewed before release, and ISO 21434 is not an exception. Therefore, it is vital to learn the language they use to understand better. Let's have a look at some screenshots from the standard. Here you can see some definitions to understand how to implement ISO text. Shall statement indicates a requirement and it starts with RQ. Should statement indicates a recommendation and it starts with RC. And may statement is used to indicate that something is permitted and it starts with PM, so which is like permission. There is also another statement which is can, that is used to indicate something is possible. For example, an organization or individual is able to do something. Can does not appear in numbered definitions like shall, should, or may, but only in notes, examples, and paragraphs. For example, you can see can is used in a note. If you occupy a role like compliance manager and you consult the ISO standards several times each day, there is a very nice and relatively short guideline mentioned here, which is highly recommended to read. And the full guideline that you can see the link here should be kept in hand to refer to whenever needed. But of course, the version provided in the slide might be obsolete anytime, so please check before using. You might see here screenshots from the full guideline that defined what is a requirement, a recommendation, and a permission. So the requirements shall have a single objective and consequently a single shall expression. And it should be, of course, verifiable. As we all know, this is a very typical definition. A recommendation conveys a suggested possible choice without any mention to verifiability. So if we see an RC or recommendation in ISO, it doesn't mean that we have to verify it, but of course it's okay to verify. A permission conveys a consent or a liberty to do something. In other words, the standard allows us to do what is being mentioned in a permission. Well, that was the end of part one. Now, here comes our questions that will allow you to test yourself. Good luck. The next module, the next part will be on ISO SAE 21434 versus UNR 155. Thanks for listening. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel and follow the LinkedIn page not to miss any updates. See you soon.